cleanse our consciences from dead works to worship the living God. Before faith came, we were under the constraint of the law, locked in until the faith that was coming should be revealed. In other words, the laws, what our monitor, until Christ came to bring our justification through faith. But now the faith is here. We are no longer your faith in Christ Jesus. All of you have been baptized into Christ, have clothed yourself with him. These do not exist among the Jews or Greek, slave or free man, male or female, all one in Christ Jesus. Furthermore, you belong to Christ. You are the descendants of Abraham, which means you inherit all that was promised. As long as the designated heir is not aged in his condition, no different from that of a slave, even though in his name he is the master of all the possessions, for he is under the supervision of guardians, administrators, until the time set by his fathers. In the same way, while we were not yet of age, we were like the slaves, subordinate to the elements of the world. But when the designated time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to deliver from the law those who were subject to it, so that we might receive our statures as adopted sons.
Hallelujah. So it pleased your only begotten Son, who is in your bosom, of God and Father, to be born of a woman, the holy Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, to be born under the law, to condemn sin in the flesh, that those who are dead and out of life be brought to life and in your praise. Living in this world, he gave us precepts for salvation. He turned us away from the deceit of idolatry and brought us to the knowledge of you, our true God and Father. He purchased us for himself as a chosen people, a royal priest, and a holy nation. He cleansed us with water and sacrificed us with the Holy Spirit. He surrendered himself as a ransom to death by which we were held captive, having been sold into slavery under sin. He sent him by the cross and made to fulfill all things in himself. He freed us from death's despair. He rose on the third day, preparing the way for the resurrection of all flesh from the dead. Since corruption could not keep the altar alive with his blindness, he became the first fruit of those who fall asleep, the firstborn of the dead, that in all things he might have preeminence over all. Ascending into heaven, he has taken his seat at the right hand of your majesty on high. He shall come again to reward everyone according to his works. But he left us these memorials of his saving passion, which he set forth according to his command. When he was about to go to his own voluntary, ever memorable life of condemned, on the night when he surrendered himself to the life of the world, he took bread into his holy bosom, your hands, he presented it to you, O God and Father. He gave thanks, he blessed, he sanctified and broke. He gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, "Take, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sin."
For the life of the world.
and confounded, a love that does not pretend to wisdom that overflows. And indeed, for the healing of our souls and bodies, the defeat of every enemy, for the full observance of your commandments, and for an acceptable defense before the face and judgment of your Christ. You are our sanctification, and we glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. So I hope that